Hi Aries, how are you doing? Welcome into your Thursday, the 11th of November tarot reading. We are going to see what's going to come in for you and what messages you need to receive for Thursday. While I'm shuffling the cards, I'm going to call in your spirit guides to please come into the spirit room, please, and to guide this reading forward, to give us the messages that we need to receive, and to please advise as well at the end of this reading. Remember, if you want to have a question answered by me at the end of every one of my tarot readings, I answer one of your guys' personal tarot reading questions. So if you want to have yours answered, check back tomorrow or the following day or even a bit later, but comment below with your zodiac sign. If you're not a Aries and you're a cross watcher, check your own zodiac the following day or the day after, and come back and see if I answer your question. Otherwise, let's get started. Don't forget to subscribe as well, otherwise you might lose the channel, okay? And then you won't know if your question's been answered. Let's get started. Let's see for you Aries what is going on here. You've got the Ten of Fire. Some stress has been going on here. This is a Ten of Wands energy. It does say too much work. I mean, isn't that just how it is these days? Accept help from others. Life is out of balance. Stress-related health concerns. Ten of Wands, there's a lot of anxiety going on here, a lot of worrying about what's going to come. You may have been going through this for a while. It almost feels like you can't do this anymore. It's like, I can't do this. I got this feeling of you going, I just feel like, look, I don't want to do this, or I can't do this, or I don't know how much longer I can do this. With the Ten of Wands being here. Let's see what else comes through. And a Knight of Fire. This could be a person that you're dealing with, okay? It says Knight of Fire, which is Knight of Wands energy, and this is also Wands as well. Passionate, adventurous, self-assured, and restless. There's the issue. A sudden event that needs immediate attention. Time is of the essence. Think things through carefully. I feel like you might be connecting to this Knight of Fire here, and this is not actually them. This is their behavior. They're not giving you stability, or they're causing some kind of unbalance in your energy because of their restlessness. And it literally says life is out of balance. I do think it's because of this person. I feel like it's this person's behavior that's causing your life to become out of balance here. They're very passionate people and very confident, and they can be very seductive as well. But basically, the Knight of Wands energy, or Knight of Fire here, they don't really actually know what they want. That's why they say they're restless. So they can come in and cause a bit of havoc in people's lives. Okay, let's see what else comes up here. The Four of Water. So they've come back. I see. Yeah, so somebody from your past here has come back with the Four of Cups. Okay, missing an opportunity, discontentment, or boredom. My goodness, open your eyes to the possibilities. If you're asking why did they come back, it can be because they are not feeling happy with themselves. Remember, when you see a Knight of Wands, they don't know the truth yet. They don't know who they are. They're still on that journey of trying to figure out who they are in life. And when this happens, they can cause problems in other people's lives. Because when they do feel bored, when they do feel unhappy, they're going to try find that to take the boredom away, or try to fill their life with something to make themselves feel better, to fill their life with something. The problem is that you cannot fill your life with something. You have to fill your life with you. And that's when you know what it is you like. You have to be happy in your own company so that you can actually achieve happiness with other people. And this person is not yet there. And that is why you got the Ten of Fire by you. The Ten of Wands, the stress, the worry, the anxiety, the drama that is getting caused by this person. So let's see. Spirit guides, please come in here and advise my Aries, please, with regards to this person or what it is they need to be looking at. I kind of see also with the Ten of Fire, you might literally be at the end of your tether, wanting to maybe release this. It may be becoming too much for you to keep on going through the situation. It could be a repetitive thing as well that's going on here. Let's see. Moon card. Yeah, they're not revealing their whole truth to you. So they may also come in because it's a very charming energy, and it shows self-assured, but it's very funny because they're actually not self-assured because they don't really know themselves. And with the Moon card coming in, yeah, there is some kind of deception or truth that they're keeping from you. So let's have a look and see. High Priestess has come up here. You need to trust your inner voice. You need to trust your intuition here with regards to this person. I think you know already that you might have to release the situation. I think you know that this person may not be that good for you. Instinctively, you can feel it, that they don't really know what they want. And that causes your life to become out of balance as well. At the end of the day, you're going to have to do what is going to take you out of this 10 of fire energy. There we go. So let's check into whose question today we are answering. It is for Miriam Paris. I think I'm saying that correctly. Hi, Miriam. How are you? You say, I am Aries. You are dealing with a Gemini. What do you see between us and will you guys reconcile? Let's have a look and see what is coming in. What is going to happen between the two of you? Are you guys going to reconcile? I want to use the tarot. I usually use tarot when I'm doing personal readings as well. I just use mainly tarot decks. So let's have a look and see. We're going to get one of the angel cards out as well. Will you guys reconcile and what can happen? I mean, it's okay if you reconcile. It can happen. What after? So that's what we need to see, hey, Miriam. So let's have a look and see what can come in here for you. Eight of Pentacles. Yeah, and they will most probably come back in here. But after, there may be some drama. So be careful. Yes, you're going to get a message from them. Look at that. You're going to get a message from this person. They will want to come in and work on something, but you got to be careful of this because that looks like there can be some pain that happens here or some kind of like hurt that happens again. So I feel like, yeah, you're going to get communication from them. They may try to reconcile with you as well because of the Eight of Pentacles being there, which shows like this hard work that is going to come in. Like, let us work on this. But I'm concerned about the Five of Cups being here. Okay, let's see what the Angel Tarot will show us. What is going on here with regards to this energy? Can this work or can this lead to heartache again? Let's see, Miriam, what's up? Let's have a look and see. Let's see, Unity. You're going to have to use your... I see a card sticking out here. I want to look at it. You're going to have to use your... The Moon card has also come in. You're going to have to use your intuition, yeah, and your wisdom. You're going to have to really go deeper and actually look at... the experience that you've experienced with them before to move you forward. Okay, literally the Moon card coming in, two major arcanas. You're going to have to go deep on this one. Archangel Sandalphon's energy, this is one of the cards of wisdom. Okay, traditional viewpoints and methods, spiritual organizations, seek out mentors and like-minded friends. It's just the meaning of this card, but it really means that you're going to have to really go deeper within yourself and look at the truth, because this card, the Moon card, kind of means you don't see the whole truth just as of yet. This is Archangel Haniel, important psychic insights. It's got to do with this wisdom. Events are happening behind the scenes. So this person is coming back in. Release fears that are holding you back. As this, I do feel like they come back in, but you're going to have to use wisdom when they do. If they come back in here and they do this again, this is this energy of you're going to have to trust your intuition and your wisdom to be able to maybe let something go that's not serving you. Because I'm a bit worried about them hurting you again. So really, as you go forward, think about this, using your wisdom, using your like your spiritual insights as well. Trust that instinct with inside of you. If you feel like somebody may come back and it can end up you being put in pain again, I mean, decide what it is that you want to experience. You know what I mean? Do you want to experience pain and heartache again, or do you want to move forward and be in a much more peaceful place? There we go. Thank you so much for coming in. I'm really wishing you the best going forward. If you guys want to have your questions answered, comment below with your zodiac sign and check back tomorrow or the following day. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.